note, and we're going to go over any section that you may need help with. What I want is, let's see, we're going to have two groups. Just scoot up, Mr. Cody, as much as you can. Scoot up, Saul. Wesley, I want you to lead Sophie through the first 30 motions.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay. Do your best with the numbers. Okay, and Declan, I want you to scoot up. Scoot over here. Right there, that's it. So now I want you to start. What you know, y'all should have enough space not to hit each other. Don't go too far with your motions. Go.
Thirty
will be stop at the cuts. Because she's done the second half already. I think last game. The whole thing with you. Scoot over more, Sophie. Try to scoot all the way down so I have a lot of space. There you go. How does it feel? Anybody have any questions? Again.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Have a seat with me. So, Yes. That's a mastermind thing for it. Think of the bars, but he used to say that. Me personally, I would understand, but I know other people would be like, shut up! I don't know what that means! I can't do that! It's a lot. Right? Right, you're gonna listen to the video later, he's like, yeah, Mr. Hunter told me to shut up. Yes, yes, yes. Boom. So you'll get the balance, but that's it. That's essentially it. Training will have to change as you get older. Of course, older in your training, like older, higher in rank. So, when you're advanced, it's good to get sequenced. So you should do all the moves together. And when you get the opportunity, right, you do the moves all together all the time so that you get them locked in, so much so that when you do get a chance to break something down, you're not lost in the set. When you come out of that motion, you're like, oh, well, what's next? So you can nitpick something and then really get back to doing what you're doing. And then you can even nitpick something as you do the whole set. So be conscious of the fact when you're getting ready to get to a part that you've been working on, then like do it differently. Consciously do it differently and move your body the way you want it to move it. Does that make sense?
Okay.
It's also easier, of course, if you have mirrors and you can see yourself. Or you can videotape yourself. Everybody has a cell phone now and everybody can set up a camera. So if you're capable of doing that and videotaping yourself, watch you do something, you'll think your stance was this deep because it felt that deep. And in real life, it was like this on video. And it sucks a little bit. As a black sash, does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So so now that you're a black sash, it should change. You really should focus on doing 5-move corrections for yourself. Does that make sense? So when you hear the nitpicky stuff that I say, sometimes it's I'll tell you too if it's an expression, like showmanship, something that I just do because I like to perform it that way. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Everybody's body moves differently, and everybody will find the little things that they'll do as long as they continue to practice. But when I tell you specific things, like especially what we learned today about how to practice and how to train and how to make it look different, when you go home, you should practice those things. Does that make sense?
Yes.
You don't have to go home as a black sash and do the whole 108. You can. Warm up, do the whole 108, but then focus on those moves that I just said. Do just these, and do the, and try to get them to where they're that rhythm, that one, and then up, boom. Make it look like that at home, and then when you come back to class, it's natural. You don't have to think about it. It just looks better because you practice. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Practice till it looks natural. Okay, keep it up. Bow to apprentice instructor, first degree, and advanced, intermediate, and Sophie. Back to the back.